Welcome everyone, it's Kirak here. Welcome to another channel update. It's been a while, so it was about time I do the channel update. I want to show off a couple of things, and then this is going to be a little bit extra special because what we're going to do is we're going to smoke some ribs together. So the first thing I want to show is the streaming room, which I've had set up for a little while now, and I've been streaming some games, and one of the games I'm currently in the middle of streaming is Uncharted 4, which is a superb game. Follow me, guys. We're gonna go check out the room. I've been streaming off and on in this room, mostly Uncharted games. I played 1, 2, and 3 in preparation for 4, and now we're finishing off 4. I just hadn't had a chance to finish it because I had an electrician in the house doing stuff. Come this way. So, ignore the mess. Come on in, come on in. You might have to do a little bit of a pan around. So this is the setup. I got a table set up. Come on this side. You can see there's a green screen in the back. This green screen was from Nomad. Nomad's holding the camera, by the way. Nomad got me this for Christmas, which was awesome. Probably the best gift ever. And you can see here, this is the setup. I got two displays set up, keyboard, PS4 is on the table. This is basically where I've been streaming from the last little while. The computer's hidden under the table, so if you look over here, as I said, don't mind the mess. I still got to clean up a bit, but the computer's down here. And yes, don't mind the boxes in the background. But it keeps the room a little bit quieter because there's more stuff in the room. And as you can see, if you look up on the walls, I threw on some like egg carton foam in different patterns right up online just to dull the sound. And it helped quite a bit because I had a little bit of an echo in this room when I first started. So this is my VR, we're going to get to that in a sec. This is my streaming setup, and I've been streaming with it, and it's been working great. The computer I got here is kind of like a mid-grade. It has like a 983X in it. Sorry, what did I just say? It has an R9 380X. That's what I meant to say. Yes, the red team. I know. It's got an i5 CPU in it, but it's more than enough for what I need to do streaming. But we started off in the other room, that's where I was seated at the beginning of this video, and there I'm going to show you the new setup. So come follow me, guys. So here, start from there and just kind of look around a bit. So basically, stay in one spot, look around. So basically this is a kitchen in the basement, but there's really no table, no nothing. The whole point behind this is I got my kick-ass system here with a GTX 980 and a GTX 770 in it. They are not SLI. Two displays, it's got an i7 processor, Devil's Canyon, and essentially this is my VR setup. So I'm getting all ready, I've been getting ready in preparation for VR, and it's gonna be amazing. So this is basically my play space. As you may know, I've ordered my HTC Vive. Once that comes in, I'm going to put one of the lighthouses there, one above where you guys are standing right now. And then I'm going to have the system hooked up here, and I'm going to have a wireless pair of headphones, which are already ready to go. And I even got a controller for the PlayStation, for the PC. It's an Xbox One controller, which works for games that support it through Steam. Some VR games need the controller, some VR games don't. They use the native tracked controllers that come with the HTC Vive. And the whole point of this is gonna be playing here. It's gonna be awesome. We had an electrician in to do some work on the house wiring. I took advantage of that and had him replace the glass lights with plastic lights, just in case one day I do one of these. you know, I don't smash and get glass everywhere, but yeah. So that's the update portion of the video. And next I'm going to be doing the actual prep for some smoked meats. We're going to be doing some ribs. All right, guys. So we're going to start setting up the meats. I'm smoking them tomorrow. I'm going to record that process as well, put it all together, and give you guys a nice little package to watch and see how to smoke ribs. We got a couple of metal trays in which I'm going to set up the ribs. saran wrap to cover them up and put them in the fridge overnight. I have two different rubs. This rub is called Memphis Dust, and it's a mixture of different herbs that I went to a bulk barn and bought and mixed all together. I found the recipe online. It's actually really good. No salt, which is good for people who don't want salt. The guy who originally created the recipe had salt in it, but he decided to pull it out. That way you can add to your liking after the fact. But there is sugar, brown sugar and white sugar. This one's a really good one. This is a rub that a good friend of mine at work got me. And it's also got some sugar, it's got salt, but it's got a completely different flavor. And I have not smoked with this yet, so I'm gonna do some of the ribs with it and see how that tastes. Oh, my mouth just watered. Got a knife so that when I open up the ribs, I'm gonna peel off the back and pull the veil off the back of the ribs. I definitely want to do that. Some people are, you know, remove it, some people are not. It's a membrane that's on the inside of the, not the meaty side of the ribs. I've tried both ways and you cannot compare. With it on, it ends up turning into like a dry piece of paper. Take them off, you will thank me for it. Paper towel, and that's pretty much it. So I'm gonna grab the ribs. And yes, we are in my VR playroom. Which is the kitchen.
Oh, jeez.
So, I'll go through the process of removing the membrane with one. That's the rib there. So let's open it up. Actually, hold on. Take my watch off. Out of the packaging. All right, so the removal of the membrane, so there's the side where the membrane is located, takes a little bit of work to get it started. You can come in close, yeah. But once you get it, then it's pretty simple or easy to peel off, unless these have already been taken off, but I don't know for sure. And I hate how they cut across because it makes it like twice the work if I need to pull off the membrane. There it is there. So sometimes you can catch it with a knife like I just did and start it right there. That little bit. And a lot of times what you can do is you can use something like a paper towel to sandwich between the, you know, your index finger and the thumb, that membrane, and then it helps you grab onto it and pull it off. Just like that. Let's see, but I'm not catching it all, because usually you could take it all off in one swipe. There we go. And that's pretty much the method I use to take it off. Whoops. Yeah, and as you can see, and this is why I don't understand why these guys, when they prep the meats, they put that cut line. Now I gotta try and do the other side. But I'm gonna do all the ribs. We're gonna be doing, these are considered a rack. I'm gonna do three racks, cut them into half racks, and those are the ribs we're gonna smoke. So I'll be back in a sec once I've got them all done. Okay guys, welcome back. So I've taken the membrane off all the ribs that I have. Here you can see the rest of the ribs. I'm gonna start seasoning up just one rack just to show you guys, and then I'll do the rest off camera, and then I'll bring you back when they're ready. And you can see here, if you come in closer, the membrane's been removed, which reveals a little bit of a layer of a fat, but you want that there because as it cooks, that fat drains off and cooks into the meat and gives it all the flavor. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use the Memphis Dust. Is it Memphis Dust? Yeah, I think that was what it was called. Well, I'll find out exactly what it was, and as I mentioned before, I'll put the recipe in the comments of this video. So basically, I'm going to grab, I keep one hand to manipulate the meat and the other hand dry so that the powder falls right off of it. And essentially, I just start sprinkling it on and coloring my meat. It's very simple, very easy.
So you want to get a good coating. A proper coating, they say, is a semi-transparent. You still want to be able to see the meat come through. But I've experimented a little bit with it, and personally, I like it when it's a little heavier than that. But as you can see, you want a nice even coating pretty much everywhere. And I just, you know, drop it on. And then eventually I'll hold it up to fill in the edges or the sides of the meat. Just like that. Get a nice little coating everywhere and then... Just like that. Corners. And what happens is, as you place the meat on, you can see it's already started to get darker. Because this, if I'm not mistaken, this recipe has a little bit of paprika in it, sweet paprika, which gives it that red color. And the moisture in the meat will start to seep through the dry rub that you've put in, which moistens up the dry rub, makes it more like a paste all over the outside. And as I mentioned previously, there is white sugar and brown sugar in this. And the white sugar and the brown sugar will actually caramelize as the meat cooks, giving it that nice little crust around the edges, which is amazing when you're chewing down on it. So this one's almost done. See that end? That's pretty much it. A touch more in the middle. And that's it. And then what I do is I just leave them in the tray and saran wrap it, which you'll see at the end, and throw them in the fridge at the end of this phase. Throw them in the fridge, and in the fridge they sit overnight. So I'll start, I'll continue with this, and then what I'm gonna do is season up the rest of these. As I mentioned before, I'm gonna use two different seasonings. So I'm gonna do most of them with this seasoning, which is the one I'm most familiar with. But then I'll do one rack or two half racks with the other seasoning my buddy gave me. Just because I've never done that before, I've never had that one before, so I don't know what that's going to come out tasting like. Oh, there we go, it's covered up. And see what it's like. If I really like it, maybe I'll get more of that and do more ribs in the future. So I'll bring you back once I have them all coated. Okay guys, so I finished doing the rubbing the meat. If you come over here, come in close, I want to show. So this is the Memphis dust. As you can see, as I mentioned earlier, all the moisture in the meat has kind of sopped in the sugars that are in the actual rub. And you can see it's given the meat a nice dark red color, which is awesome. And because of the sugars that are in there, once it cooks and caramelizes, it creates like a nice little crust on the outside of the meat, which is amazing. This one here is the other rub that my buddy gave me. I don't know what ingredients are in here because he buys it from a restaurant that uses it to smoke meats, and they basically, you can go there, dine and pay and, you know, buy smoked ribs or smoked whatever and eat. But right now what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be just covering them up with saran wrap. Let's see if we can get this. Covering them up with saran wrap and then leaving them in the fridge overnight type thing for tomorrow morning. Well, actually not tomorrow morning. I'm planning to have these for dinner, which will give them a little bit more time to sit in the fridge and absorb all the flavors. And then probably around 1 p.m. I'm going to start doing the actual smoking. I'll get the smoker going about 45 minutes before because it's got to reach temperature. And then when it's ready, I get this, cut this, get rid of that. Cut a new one. There we go. Actually long enough. Oh, handling this stuff, it's so clingy. Cover it up best I can. It doesn't have to be perfect. Just a little bit. It's not even sticking. Am I using the wrong side? I'm using the wrong side. Nope, it just don't stick. Great saran wrap. That's all right.
It's just got to keep the meat just covered a bit, you know, while it chills and absorbs all those flavors. I'm going to do the same with the second one. Here, follow me. Throw them in the fridge. And basically, leave them in there overnight. And then tomorrow afternoon, I'll get the smoker going right around noon. And I'm going to show you that part too, so don't worry. So what we'll do is we'll get the smoker going first, get it up to temperature. You want the smoker between 235, 255. Yeah, Fahrenheit. So you're basically cooking at low temperatures and you're smoking over a long period of time. And then I'll get into that process tomorrow. It's basically it's known as the 3-2-1 method, I believe, but I've modified it to the 2-2-1 method, which is 2 hours smoking, 2 hours foiled and smoking with apple juice in the foil, and then 1 hour smoking again, just to kind of dry out the meat a little bit, otherwise it comes out too fatty. So I'm going to saran wrap this, and then the next scene you're going to see is us prepping the smoker and getting the meats in the smoker. We'll see you later. Welcome back, guys. Okay, I'm going to grab the smoker now. It's the next day, ready to start. This is the smoker Nomad got me. Was two Christmases ago, and it's been amazing. I even considered buying a second one. So come on this side. So I'm gonna set it up like this. So I'm setting it up this way because the tiles, you can look down, the tiles are sloped down, and I want any liquids, any fats to go out the back, come around this way. So you can see there's a little spout at the back, and then there's a tray that I'm going to throw in there. Actually, wait right here, I'll go grab it. So this is the tray, guys, that's actually there for collecting any of the fats that come off. That tray goes in, hooks under, and then there's the spout where all the juices from the meats fall through as it's being heated and smoking, and it all collects in there. That's why I have it set at a slight angle so that gravity pulls everything towards it. We're gonna plug it in now. There we go. And the nice thing about this smoker too is it comes with a remote, which allows me to monitor the temperatures remotely. I can increase, decrease the temperatures. I can even increase and decrease the time that I wanna keep the meats in there for, which is pretty cool. So let's go over here. I'll show you real quick things that I need to get it going. Today, we're gonna try cherry wood, cherry chips. You can buy them at like Bass Pro, and I know in the US there's tons of Bass Pro. In Canada, there's only the one I know of. So these are cherry wood chips, and you add them in manually, incrementally, every so often. You'll need tongs to put the meats in. This is just regular filtered water, which I'm gonna use to fill this tray. On the inside, the tray is kneaded with liquids in order to keep the moisture in there, since it's cooking over a long period of time and low heat will eventually dehydrate, but this will keep everything nice and moist in there. And usually what I do is I put the water in and I put a little bit of apple juice in there as well. So what we're going to do next is you'll need the foil for later on, and you'll see why. I also put some of that apple juice in just a spray bottle, which I use every so often to open and spray the meats. So let's start loading up the machine just to prep it to run. So this way. So there it is there. This is after two seasons, so it's pretty black. Believe it or not, after every smoking, I pretty much clean it. I think the last one I did not clean it, so that's why it's in this shape, but it shouldn't matter, it shouldn't make a difference. There's a tray that collects the ashes as the wood chips burn out. There's another tray that siphons all the flats down to the hole, so it doesn't get into the bottom of the machine, and then out that spout you saw in the back earlier. So what we're gonna do next is we're gonna put some liquids in here. So I'm gonna put that in. Different machines have different designs where there are smaller trays. I like this one because it has a big one and it catches all the heat and all the steam comes up and gets into the meat. And you can put just water. I put water, apple juice. I've done sometimes with water and Scotch I've done, beer I've done. Apple juice is what I usually do. So you want to put some of that in there as well. More, that should be good enough. Next, I'm gonna throw in some water. There we go. Throw in the racks. So we're gonna be doing 6 half racks. Goes like this. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take 3 and leave one out since I don't really need to dirty it. And notice we're going from the bottom up, because all the heat's concentrated here and all the smoke will catch up on the top. I could throw in another rack, but there's no point dirtying it because I could fit 2, 2, and 2. And at this point, we're gonna seal it up and start it with the remote. Should be able to power it up, yep. And I'm going to put the temperatures, so here you can actually see it, you can see it here. It'll be harder to see it here, it's got an on-screen, like an actual LED at the front, at the top of it, but because it's pretty sunny, it's difficult to see the readout. So here it flips between the current temperature and what I can go to. So I'm going to say set temperature. I'm going to set that to, let's see, let's go to 235. Yeah, I know. It takes a while. Was it 230 or 130? I can't remember. Let's see what the max. What was the max? You know what? We'll go at 225. 225. Then we'll hit time. Set the time for about 6 hours. Although I'm actually going to be smoking them for about 5 hours, but I give that extra time and I can always add more. Then when I hit the time again, hit it again, and now it's heating. So now it's starting to heat. And the reason I give that time, it takes about 45 minutes for the system, see it says the red light's on now, heating, the system to reach the right temperature before I throw the meats in. So that's it for now. I'm gonna wait, throw a few chips in, get some smoke going, and then we'll get the meats and throw them in, and I'll show you that as well. See you soon. Okay, in case I missed it earlier, guys, real quick, I'm gonna show you. We're actually at temperature, we're around 230. I set it to 225, anywhere between 225, 255, you're good for cooking, for smoking. But I wanted to show this in case I missed it the last time around. You can see there's actually smoke coming out the top. I don't know if it's, if the camera can catch that or not. But this is basically where the wood tray is. So you open up the wood tray, grab the, in this case, there are chips of cherry wood, and we simply throw a bunch in. I'm not gonna use that one or that one, they don't look that good. Now you don't wanna overload it, but that's probably the max I would throw in. Enter it, twist it, and the trays drop, I mean the chips drop into the tray, and right under the tray is the heating element that burns it and turns it into ash and causes all the smoke to come up. So I'm gonna go grab the meats. I'll be right back to show you how I load the meats in. I want a lot of smoke at the very beginning. The meats are gonna be cold, and this one website that I've been visiting and getting tips and pointers on states that the smoke sticks to the meat the most at the very beginning when you put the meat in cold, okay? So we'll be back in just a sec. Okay, we're about to put the meats in. Here's the meats that we had seasoning up, or seasoned up, and you know, just sitting chilling in the fridge. This is the other dry rub that we used, and that is the regular dry rub that I used. And you can see how the meat's now all kind of moistened up with the even coating all around. So we're gonna throw it in. Follow me over here. Smoke coming out, and then we're just simply gonna take it, touch it as little as possible. Put the 2 racks in there. This one goes over here. And when you're doing this, you want to be in an area that you don't really care if any drips or drops from oil hits the ground. These are cement tiles. They'll basically, over time, wear out. It's not a big deal. We're gonna grab the other two, throw those in at the bottom. Now, one of the things that I'm doing right now, it's mainly because I'm explaining it, but I would try and do this as fast as I can because I do not want to lose the heat, because then it takes time for the heat to build up. I'm not too worried about that because of demonstration purposes. But now I seal it up, and all the smoke should stay in there at this point. And the meat now starts to cook, and it starts to collect smoke, and all that smoke adheres to the meat, and that's what gives it that nice smoky flavor. One of the things that I'm doing is I'm doing a specific method. The actual true method is 3-2-1, it's called, where you put the meats in for 3 hours, smoke them, then you take them out, foil them up, and you put whatever you want in there as a liquid in the foil to kind of like steam them almost for 2 hours, and then you take it out and you put it back in for an hour with no foil so that it kind of dries up a little bit. I've changed that a little bit, and I do that for 2 hours smoking, then 2 hours in the foil so that they cook and collect all the juices, and I put apple juice in the foil, and then I take them out of the foil and put them back in for another hour, where that kind of just reduces that moisture, that fat, that grease, and dries it up a little bit and makes it that much better. So we're gonna leave it in there. Hey Siri, come on, work. Hey Siri. Set a timer for 2 hours. Hey, that worked. supposed to be able to do it without actually touching it. There we go. So we got a 2 hour timer. In a couple of hours, my timer is going to go off. I'm going to take all the ribs out, and I'm going to foil them up, throw in some apple juice with them, put them back in for another 2 hours. When I get to that point, I'll show you how it's done. So they've been in there for about a half hour. Every 20 to 30 minutes or so, apple juice in a spray bottle. I'm going to do this fast, so I want you to come over here so you can get a good angle on this. And what I do is open it up and spray. Actually, they haven't really dried out a lot, which is okay, but adding more moisture and flavored moisture is not a bad thing, because it'll evaporate and work its way into the meat. I'm using apple juice. You can use whatever you want. I did it once with red wine. I did it once with scotch. And I can't remember what else. I did try something else, but that's basically it. So I'll bring you guys back shortly. Okay, welcome back. So we got 2 minutes before the ribs have been in there for about 2 hours. And over the course of that 2 hours, I've been adding wood, opening it up, spraying a little bit more apple juice in there, closing it back up, adding more wood, and so on. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna start the process of foiling up each half rack in foil. I've already prepared 6 sheets because I have 6 half racks. So I'm going to start. And when I do this, because I don't want to lose the heat, I'm going to pull one out, seal it up, put it down, or pull one out, put it down, seal it up. And then as I wrap it up, I'm going to add some apple juice in the wrapping with it, seal it up, open it up, pop it back in, pull another one out, and keep going. So let's begin. Ooh, that's hot, and my glasses are steamed, so I can't see a thing. And there we go. So there's one of the ribs right there. I'm going to close this up because I don't want to lose the heat in here. Looking good. Now, I want you to come a little closer. Notice how the bones are starting to show a little more. Once they come out of here, they're going to be sticking out like teeth. It's going to be awesome. So let's see if we can do this. I'll just put it on the ground. Apple juice. Grab this one there. Kind of make a little trough. There's no exact science to it. We just do the best we can. That should be good. So then, just fold it in. Cover it up. Cover it up. So it really doesn't matter how much foil you're using. The more foil you put, the less heat's going to come to the meat. But right now, we want it to cook in the liquid. We want it to cook in there. So, oh, there's the timer. So pop this open. Add it. process. And I'm going to keep going. I'm going to finish them all off and then pop them back in and show you what it looks like, okay? Be right back in a sec. All right, so this is the last of the half racks. This is the one with the other rub, the rub that my buddy got from that restaurant. I'm gonna add apple juice. I don't know how the apple juice is gonna complement it, but I need some sort of liquid. I could have used water. That's the apple juice is good. Done. Close it up. And then, that tore a bit, but that's okay. Oh no, it's spilling everywhere because it tore. Well, we'll have to put it in as it is. There we go. That one's gonna dry out a touch, but that's okay. Actually, take a look inside. So that's what it looks like now. I'm gonna close it because I don't wanna lose all the heat, but essentially each and every half rack has been wrapped up in a foil with apple juice inside. Now, we set another timer for 2 hours. Set a timer for 2 hours. And there we are. So we're all set. So in the next couple of hours, once it's all done, I'm not gonna add any more chips because the smoke won't really adhere to the meat since it's wrapped in foil. Although with some of those gaps that are in the foil, some of it may work its way in. But in a couple of hours time, we're gonna pull them out and put them in for one more hour without any foil. I'll bring you back then. Okay guys, so we are now just about 2 minutes out to the point where we need to pull them back out again. So we're going to start doing that right now. See, what I'm going to do is basically pull one out just like I did before, unwrap it, put it back in, grab the next one, unwrap it, and so on till I get all six of them done. Oh, and my glass is fogged up. Close that up so I don't lose the heat. And here we go, we're gonna unwrap them now. Look at this, let's get that. So now, come in close, I wanna show this. Notice now how the meat's pulled away from the bone and they come out sticking out like teeth? That's what you want. So I've once tried eating it straight out of the foil like this. The only thing is it's still very moist and very greasy. And you literally can only eat like half of one of these racks and then you feel sick because of all the fat. And this is why we take it out, open it up, grab that rib or that rack, half rack, throw it back in, grab the next one, and repeat the process. And then what we do is we just leave it in there for about an hour. And that little bit of extra heat, and I'm gonna smoke it as well, gives it that little bit extra flavor, dries out the meat a little bit, just enough so that the grease isn't there, and you could eat like half a rack like that, no problem. So I'm gonna keep doing this. Look at that. Oh, that's a nice one. This one didn't lose any fluids whatsoever. Put that guy back in. Oh, that tastes great. Okay. Grab the next one. I'm gonna finish them up, leave them in there for an hour, and then bring you guys back for the final removal and taste test. See you in a little bit. All right, guys. It's all done. I am ready to pull them out, so let's pull them up. Ah, check it out. Homemade smoked ribs. Look at that. And look how the bones just come out. Looks like restaurant style. These are the other ones. I'm gonna put these layered in between with a different seasoning. Oh my God, my mouth is watering so much. This and that. There you go. So follow me over to the table. These are the ribs, smoked ribs, cherry wood smoked ribs with apple juice and the Memphis dust seasoning or rub. I'm gonna cut one and I'm gonna have Nomad try it out. So let's cut this one here. Look at that, pull apart. Look at that, I'm gonna leave that right there. Nomad, here, hand me the camera. I want you to give that a try. So? Are they good? Oh yeah. Did the greasy taste go away? The greasy there's no greasy taste, right? Yeah.
No.
And that's what that 1 hour at the end, uncovering them from the foil, does. It basically dries up all that grease, so now it's like eating a nice dry piece of rib meat. And that will give you the best flavor and taste. Ooh. And you can keep eating as many as you want. All right, so while my brother is pigging out right now, and believe me, I want to join in, I'm gonna end it here. So I hope you guys enjoyed that, and thank you for joining us for the smoking of some ribs. I've been doing this for the last couple years. This will be the third season, and I'm enjoying it very much. And I'm trying different things. Chicken. One thing I haven't done is salmon, and I want to smoke some salmon, so I'm going to do that this season. Maybe when I do that, I'll record it and show you guys as well. But anyways, thank you for joining me. I really appreciate you guys coming along. And bye for now.